Everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we are going to be learning about Nuxt Image. So first of all, we'll cover what Nuxt Image is, some of the benefits you get out of using it, why should you use Nuxt Image in your Nuxt app, and we'll also look at how to actually use it and what are some performance benefits you get out of it. So let's get right into the main video. In case this is the first time you're hearing about this, this is one of the modules that Nuxt provides out of the box for you to use when building a Nuxt application. And Nuxt Image is a module that allows you to optimize the images you use within your Nuxt app. It helps you to resize and transform your images using the built-in optimizer or with several different image CDN providers that you can pick from that would help you optimize your images. So the goal here is to ship images that are optimized when building with a Nuxt app, and with this Nuxt Image module, it does an excellent job of making sure that all your images are optimized. If this is your first time of hearing about Nuxt, Nuxt is a Vue.js meta framework that helps you to build web applications. And the great thing about it, or one of the features that I really like about it, is that Nuxt.js is built with a modular architecture in mind. What this basically means is that you can extend the core of Nuxt by adding modules to your Nuxt app. And there are over more than 50 modules that you can use to build your Nuxt app, which is one of them is the Nuxt Image that I'm going to be covering in this video. So Nuxt is a great framework. I just wanted to put it out there in case you're not familiar with it. Now that we've established what Nuxt Image is, why should you then use it in your Nuxt application? What are some of the, you know, benefits you get out of using Nuxt Image over just using the native image tag when you need to add images to your Nuxt app? I'm going to go over some of the important, you know, features you get out of using the Nuxt Image module, and still in the course of the video show you the differences, or just show you a demo of using the native image tag and Nuxt Image component, and just show you the performance improvements that happens when you use Nuxt Image components. Just to note that Nuxt Image is a drop-in replacement of the native image tag, so what you still get at the end, still an image tagged with some additional optimization added on top of it. So some of those features you get is, first, Nuxt Image uses a built-in provider that allows you to optimize both local image and remote images. It automatically resizes the images that you have based off the width and height. It can also generate responsive sizes for your images, as long as you provide it with a sizes option. And finally, it supports native lazy loading. Now let's walk through how to use Nuxt Image in your Nuxt application. Right here, I have a demo of an image and text on a page. Just very straightforward. And for now, this image that you see is just the native image tag that's being used there and nothing else. I have it here, just an image coming from the local folder in the images directory, and that's it. This is great, it works, but if we want to add additional features like I mentioned earlier, we can then go ahead and use the Nuxt Image module. And to do that, we only need to set it up using two things. First, we need to install, make sure that we have it installed, which I already have here, Nuxt Image as a dev dependency. And in your nux.config.js file, make sure that you add it to the build modules. By doing these two things, you can use the Nuxt Image component or the Nuxt picture component anywhere in your component, and you'd see it working. So instead of this image that we currently have here, I'm going to comment this out. Go ahead and replace that with the Nuxt Image component with the same image we're using in the image tag above. Now what we get is exactly the same image we had before, and it's important to note that Nuxt Image component would always render
an image tag for you in the browser. So it's a drop-in replacement for the native image tag. But with this, you have additional benefits that you can add to this image to even make it more optimized. And there are several different props that you can add to your image. One of them is called sizes. This would help you create responsive sizes for your image based on the size that you assign to it. So here's an example. We have this same image, but we want it to resize on each of these viewports. So in a small screen size, it should be 50 viewwidth, right? In a medium screen size, it should be 150, and in the large, it should go above that. Now, if I show you what this Nuxt image component does, it creates three different images for us with these sizes. I'm just going to show you that so you see. So we have this image here, right? I told you that it's always going to be replaced by a native image tag. But then if you check the source set attribute right there, you see that we have three images generated. We have the first image with the width of 320. We have the other images with several widths for the several different screen sizes, screen resolution that we assigned to it. So that's something you get out of the box with Nuxt image. Another thing you can also do is changing the format. So you have this thing called this other prop called format that can allow you change the format of the image. Right now, the format that I have is JPEG, but I can assign an even optimized format to my image that is rendered in the browser, WebP. We all know that WebP is a more optimized version of other images like JPEG and PNG. So what happens here to our image is that the format is changed. So you have this additional query parameter added, so URL for the image that makes it change the format to WebP. To confirm this, if I try downloading this image, what I get is the WebP format. That's just amazing. That's awesome. The last thing I would like to cover here is the provider. Provider is another prop you get when you're using Nuxt image component. And what this does for you is, instead of using the default provider, you can choose to use several different services that already allows you optimize your images. For example, one of these services or platforms is called Cloudinary. Cloudinary is an image CDN that we can use as a provider. And what it does for you is it allows you to transform, optimize your images and store them. And then you can use it in your app. In our case, I want to use Cloudinary, and I already set it up, configured it in my nux.config.js file by setting a base URL for my Cloudinary image. And what I just need to do is here, add the providers to be Cloudinary and also use the URL for the image that I'm taking from Cloudinary. And for me, that is actually different. So I'm just going to copy it here. So this is the new URL for our image. And if I go back here and refresh, I should still see the same image. And in this case, the wonderful thing that it does is it uses the sizes that we set. So I'll just show you what I mean here. So this is our image, right? Our image is here. If you notice, all the images no longer come from the local directory, but they are all coming from Cloudinary. But the amazing thing that happens here is, based off the sizes prop that we set, all the images are still responsive, and Cloudinary added the width that we assigned for each of the sizes of the screen. Isn't that amazing? Yeah, it works. So if I refresh my screen size, I should see them change as expected. That's just very nice. I'm taking a bit of a detour to share with you a platform that I came across recently called Sourcegraph. Sourcegraph is a platform that allows you to search for open source code or your own publicly accessible code. And you can search for code in several different contexts. So you can either be looking for a code on a specific repo, or you can be looking for a code based off a commit you made, for example, last week, or you can actually add a combination of filters when you're searching for code. So you can search for a code in a specific repository using a specific language and for a specific file extension type. There are just a lot of things you can do with this tool. And I figured, why not try to see how other people are using Nuxt Image, since that is what we're covering in this video. So I obviously want to test it out, so I'm just going to go ahead and search for Nuxt Image. And let's see what comes up. So in my head, I'll think that I would find a whole lot of search, because I know that a lot of people have used Nuxt Image in their repos. The good thing is you can search with several different filters. For example, you can search for a specific repo using this repo keyword, or if you have a file in mind that you're looking for, a view file, markdown file, you can also say file, only return file, for example, type of markdown. And you get that. You can also say, I only want to return code that was committed in the last week or before specific time. So using the after or the before keyword. And I'm interested to see how people have been using Nuxt Image. So I'm just going to generally search for Nuxt Image. I don't want to return any search from the main Nuxt Image repo. And that's where the operators come in. So I can decide to exclude a specific repo from the general search that is returned. So in this case, I'm going to use the not, so in caps, use the not operator and tell it not to return the Nuxt Image repo. And now the results we would get in this case is going to be all the results with the Nuxt Image component in it, excluding any results coming from Nuxt Image repo. And from here, I can see that several people are using it in their repositories. This is the Nuxt modules repo using Nuxt Image. That's nice. We also have this other repo using it. So we can see a lot of examples of how people are using Nuxt Image here. I see here that this repo is using it with the Cloudinary provider. That's interesting to see. I think this too would help me when I'm looking for example, searching for specific code in a very large code base, or for example, looking for instances of where a specific code has been used. In our case, that's what we just tried to do. And so to wrap up this video, I'd like to thank you for watching all the way to the end. I hope right now you understand what Nuxt Image module is and you're excited to use it in your Nuxt app. Please let me know what you all think about this, and if you have any questions, just let me know in the comment section. Thank you, and I'll see you in my next video.